IoT botnets could turn your smart home devices against you. Hold on to your keyboards, tech enthusiasts, because today we're diving deep into the hidden realms of the Internet of Things, uncovering the shocking and somewhat sinister world of IoT botnet attacks. From devices secretly plotting against us to cyber criminals pulling the strings, it's a tale of technology gone rogue. Are you ready to explore the dark side of technology? Buckle up and let's unravel this digital mystery. In this gripping episode, we're shining a spotlight on IoT, those nifty gadgets and gizmos that make our lives so connected and convenient. But here's the twist. What happens when these devices turn against us? We're talking about IoT botnets, the digital armies of compromised devices, controlled by unseen hands, launching attacks that can cripple websites, steal your data, and hold the digital world up for ransom. Get ready to witness the scale of the threat as we delve into real-world attacks that shock the cyber world. Remember the 2016 attack that brought down giants like Amazon and Twitter? Well, the MyRai botnet wreaking havoc in Libya. We've got all the chilling details, but fear not, we're not leaving you in the dark. We've got your back with expert tips and tricks on how to shield yourself from these invisible invaders. So gear up, tech warriors. It's time to embark on a thrilling journey, uncovering secrets, facing dangers, and learn how to defend our connected world. Are you with us? Let's dive in. IoT, Internet of Things, refers to online, interconnected devices that collect and exchange data. This broad category of devices includes sensors, cameras, network routers, and advanced machinery, and their integration into everyday life and work processes results in an ecosystem that automate operations, improve decision-making, and enhance user experience. An IoT botnet is a collection of compromised IoT devices such as cameras, routers, DVRs, wearables, and other embedded technologies infected with malware and controlled by a cyber criminal. Cyber criminals can use IoT botnets to launch a variety of attacks, including distributed denial of service or DDoS attacks, data breaches, and ransomware attacks. IoT botnets are particularly dangerous because they can be used to launch attacks from a large number of distributed locations. This can make them difficult to defend against and can cause widespread damage. A number of IoT devices is growing rapidly, and so too is the number of IoT botnets. In 2022, there were over 16 billion connected IoT devices worldwide. This number is expected to grow to over 30 billion by 2025. As the number of IoT devices grows, so too does the opportunity for cyber criminals to create and exploit IoT botnets. There have been a number of high-profile IoT botnet attacks in recent years. Here are just a few examples. In 2016, a massive IoT botnet was used to launch a DDoS attack against the dying DNS service. This attack caused outages for many popular websites, including Amazon, Twitter, and Netflix. In 2017, the MyRai botnet was used to launch a DDoS attack against the Liberia Broadcasting System, LBS. This attack knocked the LBS offline for several days and caused widespread disruption in Liberia. In 2021, the Cassia ransomware gang used a compromised IoT device to launch a ransomware attack against over 1,500 businesses worldwide. This attack caused millions of dollars in damage and disrupted operations for many businesses. These attacks are just a few examples of the growing threat of IoT botnets. As more and more devices are connected to the internet, the risk of IoT botnet attacks is only going to increase. IoT botnet attacks targeted devices with shared internet connectivity, such as smartphones, smartwatches, and laptops. These bots can be non-invasive. They stay in the background until the actors trigger a particular action. A typical IoT botnet attack plays out in numerous ways. Identify weaknesses and target. The first step in an IoT botnet attack is finding a way to get into the targeted device. Every application looks secure on the surface, but most systems have some known or unknown vulnerabilities. It depends on how far you look. They scan for loopholes until they find one and leverage it to gain access. After discovering a weakness in the system, threat actors infect it with malware that spreads across all devices on the shared IoT network. Connect device to server. IoT botnet attacks aren't random. Attackers plan their activities and initiate them from remote locations. The next step is to connect the devices to servers in the hacker's control room. Once they establish an active connection, they roll out their action plan. The shared connection among IoT devices works to the threat actor's advantage. It enables them to compromise multiple applications with a single command, saving time and resources. The botnet hacks the device and gains access, and then the loader server installs malware on it. The attacker then gains permanent access to the device and attaches it to the botnet. Here are the stages of infecting IoT devices and connecting them to a botnet. A attacking IoT devices. Cybercriminals use a variety of methods to attack IoT devices, including phishing attacks, malware infections, and exploiting known vulnerabilities. Building a botnet. Once a cybercriminal has compromised a sufficient number of IoT devices, they can build a botnet. This is done by installing malicious software on the compromised devices that gives the cybercriminal control over them, launching the attack. Once the cybercriminal has built a botnet, they can use it to launch a variety of attacks. This could include a DDoS attack, a data breach, a ransomware attack, or another type of attack. Initial command. The attacker uses a CNC server to send a command to the botnet for attacking and incorporating new devices. Scanning and compromise. The botnet scans and compromises victims' devices to gain privileged access by brute forcing weak passwords or exploiting outdated firmware or insecure configurations. Data reporting. The botnet relays the victim's IP address and access credentials to the loader server once the device is hacked. Malware delivery and infection. The loader server sends malware or malicious instructions, which are then executed by a compromised device, turning it into a bot. Joining the botnet. The newly infected device becomes part of the botnet and awaits further commands, often operating undetected. How dangerous are IoT botnets? IoT botnets can be used to launch a variety of attacks, including DDoS attacks. IoT botnets can be used to launch DDoS attacks against websites, businesses, and governments. These attacks can cause outages and financial losses. Data breaches. IoT botnets can be used to steal data from businesses and consumers. This data can be used for identity theft, fraud, and other crimes. Ransomware attacks. IoT botnets can be used to launch ransomware attacks against businesses and consumers. Ransomware attacks encrypt data and demand a ransom payment to decrypt it. Espionage. IoT botnets can be used to spy on businesses and governments. This information can be used for espionage, blackmail, and other malicious purposes. How to protect yourself from IoT botnet attacks? There are a number of steps that businesses and individuals can take to protect themselves from IoT botnet attacks. These steps include doing your research. Before buying an IoT device, research its security features, vulnerabilities, and user reviews to make an informed decision. Change default passwords. Change the default password on your IoT device to prevent unauthorized access and use strong, unique passwords to enhance security. Separate your IoT device network. Create a separate network for your IoT devices to prevent attackers from accessing other sensitive data on the same network. Use firewalls and router security features. Disable unused features. Turn off unused features like Universal Plug and Play, UPnP, on IoT devices to reduce the risk of vulnerabilities that hackers can exploit. Keep device software and firmware updated. Regularly update your IoT device's software and firmware to patch security vulnerabilities and minimize the risk of attack. Another important step is to raise awareness of the threat of IoT botnets and how to protect against them. Businesses and individuals need to be aware of the risk and take steps to protect themselves. IoT botnets are a serious threat, but there are steps that businesses and individuals can take to protect themselves. By following the steps, you can help to reduce your risk of becoming a victim of an IoT botnet attack. I hope you learned a lot about IoT botnets, their attack processes, and precautions associated with them. Stay safe from IoT botnets, and don't forget to subscribe to Hacker's Journal. Hit that notification button to get all the informative videos from us. Now it's time to say goodbye. Stay safe.